Just a few words to say that now I feel very proud because the Mayor of Porto honored the political courage of people like Jorge Sampaio, and so we can say that it maintains the tradition when he decides that the DCR is going to be open in Porto. So thank you very much, Mr. Rui Moreira, Mayor of Porto. The next speaker, I can say it's a friend, but I could not say that because she's a Health Secretary of State now. Raquel de Almeida Ferreira Duarte is the Secretary of State of Health in Portugal. She's a pulmonologist at the Hospital of Vila Nova de Gaia Espinho. She holds a Master on Public Health, a Master in Management and Health Systems Economics, and a PhD on Public Health. Amongst her career achievements, Dr. Duarte is the former coordinator of Portugal National Program Against Tuberculosis and assistant professor at the Institute of Public Health of the University of Porto, ISPUP, the vice president of the International Union Against Tuberculosis, a lung disease, as well as chair of tuberculosis working group of the European Respiratory Society. Raquel, please take the floor and say your speech. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I am really, really delighted to be here with you today at this 2019 Harm Reduction International Conference. I'd like to start thanking Mrs. Naomi Burkshain, Executive Director of the Harm Reduction International, Mr. José Queiroz, that is my friend, and Director of APDES, for the opportunity to be a part of the 2019 largest International Harm Reduction event and for its excellent organization. I would also like to express my gratitude and honor for sharing this opening ceremony with the High Commissioner for Human Rights, Mrs. Michelle Blanchet, with the former Portuguese President Jorge Sampaio, with Mr. Rui Coimbra Moraes from Consumidores Associados Sobrevivem Organizados, and Mr. Alexandre Quintanilha, scientist and leader in the Portuguese drug policy reform. Over 4 days of presentations, workshops, and networking events, we expect a major reflection about the devices for harm and risk reduction that we consider essential in our policies. In the context of drug-related policies, the first National Drug Strategy, whose 20th anniversary we celebrate in the coming weeks, has provided a balanced approach between supply reduction and reducing demand in the context of drug-related policies. I remember that it was approved by the Portuguese government in 1999. These policies and this balanced approach to the illicit substances have been successful, and therefore we have extended the concept not only to the controlled substances but to all addictive behaviors. Portugal's approach is a well-known model of best practices because we are fully committed to the principle of drug control conventions based on principle of proportionality, respect for human rights, putting health and welfare in the center. Drug addiction and substance addiction is a health problem first and foremost. But we are still concerned about the future. We are not a country free of drugs, free of addiction, and mostly about access to legal substances such as alcohol, tobacco, and other behaviors such as gambling. The regulation of this access, which we can consider as environmental prevention, is also extremely crucial and important to us. In terms of prevention and in the context of demand, we have several strategies, and we try to go beyond mere information about risks and harms of drugs, but we want to favor the capacity of resilience and the capacity of making conscious choices about the behaviors we adopt. We try not to diminish our fellow citizens or use the connotation of certain behaviors as addictions or even sins. We do not believe in just saying no. We want to help people understand why to say no. The strategy settles in several core values, of which I highlight the humanism and pragmatism as the most relevant, and we heard about them today. If humanism leads us to consider the dignity of the human being in all circumstances and its condition as a citizen with rights and duties, pragmatism leads us to recognize that the same human being under specific conditions is enslaved by dependence and inability to self-determine. It is fundamental that we support that same human being regaining the most basic levels of human dignity so that he can therefore make a conscious choice. We are attentive to the responses that other countries have applied, and we also support the evidence that the EMCDDA helped us to compile. We have extended the range of responses. We have also advanced legislation in harm reduction, which gives space to find answers we believe are the most appropriate to the problems faced, as is the creation of monitored consumer programs. The success of these policies, like the needle exchange program, has contributed to a decrease in injectable consumption. But we are far away from being free of addiction. And in recent years, above all in the aftermath of the economic and social crisis that has affected us, we have witnessed the recruitment of old consumption by injection. We therefore support the initiative of a consortium of NGOs supported by the Lisbon City Council that allowed recent opening of the mobile monitored consumption space in Lisbon and now also in Porto, which will soon be followed by the creation of fixed space in Lisbon. And it's very good for us all. Life is an absolute value that knows no borders, no differences. It's for the defense of a better life that we meet here. I want to warmly welcome you all here in this conference. I hope you all share your experience, share your knowledge. We all win with that. And I wish you a very, very well stay in Portugal, in this extraordinary city. I must say, this is my home, so I hope you like it as much as I do, and I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you.